morning to St. Peter's in Washington, the Episcopal Church. We will be celebrating spiritual communion this morning for the second Sunday in Advent. And we again welcome you for the service. Forsake our sins, that we may greet with joy the coming of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem, and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, "Cry out," and I said, "What shall I cry?" All people are grass. Their consistency is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades. When the breath of the Lord has blown upon it, surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Give to your high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom, and gently lead the mother sheep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Since all these things are to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be in leading lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be set ablaze and dissolved, and the elements will melt with fire? But in accordance with his promise, we wait for new heavens and a new earth, where righteousness is at home. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of our Lord as salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Come now, Lord. the beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight.' John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And the people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, 'The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
"Comfort, comfort ye my people, says your God." These words from the prophet Isaiah serve as some of the most sustaining words of Holy Scripture. Most likely these words were written by a Hebrew prophet living in Babylonian exile and written to his Hebrew brothers and sisters sharing that exile. They were a people forced from their homeland, many of whom felt abandoned by Yahweh, their God. And Isaiah says to them, "Comfort, comfort, my dear friends. You are not alone. You are not abandoned. Indeed, your God is coming to you out of exile to lead you like a shepherd, to hold you in his bosom, and to gently bring you home." And indeed, within a very few years, God did return God's people to Jerusalem. God indeed did lead them home. There is a sense in which the season of Advent is both the preparation for the coming of our Lord, but also a prelude to our own homecoming. These 4 weeks of Advent are intended to prepare us for the coming of Jesus, our Messiah. It is a specific time of the year when the Church calls each of us to introspection and evaluation, to be intentional about the nature of our lives, who we are, and what we are doing. And it is also a time of penitence, a time to get straight with God, if you will, a time to acknowledge our sins and errors and the foolishness of our ways. It is a time to work at cleaning up our lives, that we might be prepared to receive the innocence of the Christ child into our hearts. We are being prepared for the coming of our Lord. This season is also a prelude to our homecoming. For the ancient Hebrews, their home was Yahweh's, but Jerusalem was the sign that they were going to come home. For us, our home is to be with God. But the sign of that homecoming is the presence of Jesus in our lives, the willingness to accept him into our lives as our personal Lord and Savior. Our home is in God, and to be at one with God. Think for a moment what home means. It is a place of refreshment, a place of security and comfort, a place of nourishment and warmth. It is a place where we can be ourselves, and yet a place where we can be challenged to grow and mature as human beings. This is what a healthy home looks like, And it is the home God offers us within himself. To be with God. And to be with God is to find a place of refreshment, a secure and nourishing abode, a place where we can grow to become the person God wants each one of us to be. It seems to me, however, that our lives indicate that we are more often in exile than at home. There are many lonely places in our lives, some frightening places, some places of sadness, and sadness and disappointments. You can name these places in your souls. And indeed, part of the exhortation of the Advent season is to be willing to acknowledge those places. Not so we can wallow in them, but so we can be honest with ourselves about whom we are and what we are truly experiencing in the depths of our own being. Because it is at that point we can be most open to inviting Jesus into our lives. Jesus' opening words to us in such circumstances is comfort. Comfort my child. We are called to the realization that Jesus wants to partner with us in our journey homeward, our journey toward God. Jesus is with us in our places of exile to sustain and strengthen us, but that is not where he wants us to live. Jesus wants us at home with God. Home may be the restoration of a relationship with a person we once cherished. Home may be the alleviation of an anxiety we have about ourselves or our child. Home may be an ointment that soothes our conscience over a terrible indiscretion. It may be a balm that heals a physical malady, or a peacefulness of the soul that accepts the finiteness of our human being. Home is the place we hear the prophet say, "Comfort, comfort my people, says your God." And home is the place we hear Jesus say, "Come unto me, all you that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you." Let us take this opportunity these next few weeks to come home, to be with Jesus, and invite him into our lives, that we might be refreshed, that we might be sustained, that we might be comforted, that we might be made whole. Amen. Amen. Please join with me in the Nicene Creed.
Incarnate from the earth.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to the honor of your and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit, and give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
This morning we especially remember these people, Ryan Alderman and his family, Ryan Alligood, David Barilla, Maria Vanez, Charlotte Grace Butler, Matthew Burns, Charles Cantwell, Megan Carpenter, Shirley Cosby, Patricia Coffey, Calvin Cooks, Dwayne Davis, Diane Furlow, Camden Green, Sam Grimes, Crystal Hart, Shelby Harris, the Reverend Jim Horton, Jay Marr, Kim Molden, Joyce Nelson, Helen Nicholson, Zoe Potts, Angela Powers, Charlotte Reynolds, Marinina and Shannon Robinson, Phil Riders, April Stations, Amy Sazman, Grover and Carol Sawyer, Jenny Singleton, Larry Smithwick, Douglas and Myra Steph, Rick Stevens, Gary Strine, Carolyn Thomas, Barbara Winfield, David Woolard. And we also pray for those who came seeking financial assistance this week, Sheree, Brittany, and Tawain.
Before we continue, I also want you to remember in your prayers Mavis and Rudy Burns, both of whom are suffering from COVID. And when I talked to Mavis this afternoon, they were picking Rudy up to carry him to High Point, North Carolina, to a rehab. He seems to be doing okay, except his strength is really, really down. So if you would keep those books in your minds as well, please. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Remember the words of our Lord Jesus, I said, it's more blessed to give than to receive.
Glory of your name.
Glory, glory, glory.
in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death,
we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory.
And we offer you our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and the blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with St. Peter and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray.
Eternal God,